check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Hey Bells, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to give you guys a tour of my bedroom. So I definitely wanted a boutique hotel vibe. That was what I was going for. I wanted to incorporate blacks and whites and silver, and my favorite color being gold. I wanted to make sure that that was accented throughout the room, and I wanted it to be like very romantic, classy, sexy. I had a lot of expectations. I wanted to walk into my room and just feel like I was walking into a romantic setting. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm single, so I wanted my bedroom to make love to me. I literally pulled out my actual vision board and I looked at everything on it and I was like, okay, how can I incorporate these ideas into my room? Your environment can really transform your state of mind. If you walk into your bedroom and it's giving you all of your vibes, everything that speaks to you, that inspires you, that moves you, it just makes waking up in the morning and going to sleep at night just a little bit easier. Right. So one of the first things you'll see when you enter my bedroom is my vanity area. This desk I actually purchased from IKEA. Most of my IKEA furniture I've had for a good 10 years, including this desk. And I think it was like $40 at IKEA, but it has held up very well. So I bought that there. The ottoman is from Joss & Main, which is like a sister company, I guess, to Wayfair. This little box in here. This is where I store my sunglasses and my watches. So I recently did like a huge purge of all of like my wardrobe, all the pieces that weren't quality pieces that I no longer wore or that I didn't feel like it would have any longevity to it. That's why that's a little empty right now. She's in the process of being refilled. If you guys follow me on Instagram, my Instagram stories specifically, I mentioned how I wanted to get something for my makeup to organize it because I had originally had a black acrylic organization system here. So I just got my toiletry bag. I filled my makeup up with that instead and put that on my vanity. And I think it just looks a lot better. It looks a lot cleaner. I don't wear that much makeup, so that's really all that I need. And then I put my makeup brushes in this nice little crystal cup. I got this cup off of Wayfair. And don't worry, I'm actually cleaning my brushes today, so, you know, ignore that. And then this crystal heart I added, it's a paperweight. I found this in my basement randomly, so I cleaned it off and I added that to my vanity. The mirror I actually stole from my mother. She wasn't using it, so it was more like it was gifted, okay? And I love this mirror so much. It's a nice snake print detail, which I felt was so beautiful because you'll notice throughout my room, there's a lot of texture, there's a lot of detail in a lot of my pieces. So I thought that was a good little addition. And then in the corner, I just have pictures of my mom and myself. And yeah, that's it. Everything is very simple, you guys. I have a pretty small space, especially because, you know, the ceilings are slanted. So I didn't want to overwhelm the space by putting out too many things and causing clutter. You'll notice everything's a little bit lower in this room. Because of that, I don't have that much wall space. So when I do my makeup, I normally just move the ottoman out in front of this mirror. And, you know, I'll use the desk to put my makeup on and do my makeup here instead. So moving on to this mirror, this is a $10 mirror that I purchased from Target. I do own the IKEA Hovet mirror that I had originally had in my old room, which was much bigger than this room. But this room, the ceilings are much lower, the space is much smaller, so unfortunately that mirror, it tries, but it does not fit in the space at all. And I just purchased adhesive that I got off of Amazon to hold it up to my door. And then I have a little clothing hook at the top that I purchased from Wayfair. All right, so that's the mirror. And then moving on, this is another piece from IKEA, part of their mom collection. Again, I've had this dresser for, or this, you know, drawer unit for almost 10 years now. So it's a little rough, you know, she got a little scrapes and scratches on her, but it's held up pretty well. On top of it, I just have this gold mirrored tray. I purchased this tray off of Wayfair, and on this tray, I pretty much just carry my favorite like body moisturizers and oil. And then I have a candle here. This candle came in a set that I purchased from IKEA for like 12 bucks. A little crystal that I think means something with trust and love and all that jazz. Some charcoal sticks that I got from Anthropologie that actually broke, so I just tied them up in this little piece of cloth. But charcoal sticks are supposed to just help with deodorizing your room, so I have that there. And one of my favorite pieces in my room is this candle that I got off of Pottery Barn, again with the croc print that I love. This is an LED candle and it's timed, so every evening at 6 p.m. this goes off. If you don't have a timer LED candle, I would really consider purchasing one. It is such a vibe in your space, and this has like a nice yellow tint, so it's very true to what a real candle looks like. And then this is a little vase filled with these dried up flowers. I don't know what to call these. I forget what these are actually called, but I purchased these from Michael's. I actually want to go back and get some more just to fill this up a little bit. And then this clear vase I found lying around my house somewhere. All right, and then in this corner is where I have all my, well, not all my clothes, but a good amount of my clothes in this corner. I also have some of my shoes here. I have some storage underneath, like my carry-on bag and things like that. Because I'm working with a small space, I had to get really creative with what I did with my stuff. So I decided to just pull in my rolling rack, put my clothes in this corner. And then I got these little clear acrylic shelves from the Container Store. And then beside it, I have another mom dresser from IKEA. Again, 10 years strong. She's been going 10 years strong. So yeah, it's my TV. I have some candles, a clock, and a vase with flowers. These candles, again, the set that I purchased from IKEA, and this clock I actually got off of eBay. You can see some of the damage to these dressers back when I did not give two craps about them. This clock I purchased from eBay. I got it from eBay for $25. It is a wind clock, so I'm not gonna lie, I don't use this shit at all. It's purely for aesthetics. I started using it, but having to wind this up every week, I was like, I don't have time for that. And then this floral arrangement I got from Michael's. I literally sat in an aisle at Michael's one day and just like pulled a whole bunch of pieces together. I think there are maybe like 5 or 6 pieces that I combined, and I got this cute little bouquet. And I used some of the dry florals, whatever, that I showed you guys on top of the other dresser. And I think that looks so beautiful. I don't know, I really like how it came out. And it looks pretty real to me too. She cute. The vase I also got from Michael's, just a gold glass situation. So that's all, very simple on here. Then moving on to this corner is where I have my little sitting area. Again, these damn ceilings, I don't normally sit here. I definitely don't sit here to read, but I will sit here sometimes to work on my laptop. Strangely enough, it is kind of comfortable. Like, I'll slouch over and work on my laptop. I got the chair from Overstock. I forget how much it costs, but I'm so happy that I got it, y'all, because when you look at my space and you see all the black in the space, it could be a little overwhelming. And so I was originally going to get this chair in black, and I'm like, that's a little too much. So I decided to get it in an emerald green, and I'm so happy that I did. I feel like it matches the decor of just like boutique meets Victorian meets classy meets elegant meets sexy, you know. So yeah, that's it. Underneath the chair, I just have these beautiful boxes where I keep like my sentimentals in it. I keep some of my old candles in there as well, and they're like they're wooden boxes, so they're very sturdy as well. Then I also have some pictures of myself up on these walls. And one of my favorite pieces in this room is actually these picture frames. Let me get up a little closer so you can see. I apologize for my creaking floors, okay? This is the old house. I found these off of gilt.com. I think they were like $25 each. And I just have some pictures, me at one of my editorial parties, one of my favorite pictures. Can I say that? I really love this picture of myself. Okay. And then another picture also in honor of my brand, just wearing my little I Am Belle bracelet. Then next to the picture frames, I just have a window here. I actually have two windows in this bedroom. The other one is behind my TV. So unfortunately, the light that comes in is a little bit limited. But here's the second window. And I got these sheer drapes also from Wayfair. I love them because of the texture. Like I told y'all, I just really, really love texture. I love pieces with subtle detail like this. And the sheerness, of course, gives you ultimate boutique hotel vibes. So I put them as high as possible to get as much length in the space as I could. So yeah, I love these. Over here, I have one of my favorite pieces of art. This is from an artist. I believe his name is Milov. I forget his first name, but he's a Ukrainian artist and he did this sculpture at the Burning Man Festival back in 2015. And I was randomly reading an article and I saw it, you guys, and I fell in love with the sculpture. Look how beautiful that is, you guys. You know, you could definitely tell the meaning behind this. It's so apparent, but it's one of those pieces of art that's so simple but so powerful. Like it says so much. I freaking love it. This isn't his actual design or sculpture. This I found off of, I think it was like called Society 29 or something like that, but it's a replica of what he did, which just represents your inner child and how our inner children want to connect, want to love, want to play. But I think as adults, you know, we go through so much misery and pain and heartache and all that shit, and we compromise what is naturally in us, you know, this willingness and this longing to just love. So one of my favorite pieces. Over here, I have my nightstand. Again, I've had this for a good 10 years, so there's a lot of wear on there. I have another candle for my IKEA set, a picture frame, this beautiful, beautiful wall sconce, which definitely adds to the boutique vibes. I got the wall sconce off of Wayfair, and I got, you know, another one for the other side as well. This vase I got off of Amazon, and I just purchased these black eucalyptus stems from Michaels. If you know me from Belle, these are actually one of the vases that I had at my editorial party. So I just took it and put it in my bedroom. I thought it was cute in that corner. Then off to the other side before I get to my bed is the other nightstand. This is the newer one that I just purchased maybe like a couple weeks ago. Like 2 or 3 weeks ago. So obviously it looks a lot better. I actually ordered some custom coasters and a tray from a black owned brand. She's making me a custom tray so that I could protect that the top of that a little bit. So I'm really excited to get that. Of course, the other wall stones and then a picture of myself when I was a little baby. So moving down to this rug, which I really love. I purchased it off of Etsy. The only thing is I thought it was much bigger than what it is because I was looking at another rug that was longer and I confused the two. So I love the shape of this. I love the look of it, but I just wish it was a little longer because my flooring is really old. It's the original hardware. I believe it's the original hardware of the home. So it's really discolored and I didn't want to bother redoing my floors because it's not that bad. It's really this one area. So I was trying to get something to cover that up, and now we got this little bite-sized rug. So off to my bed. This is my favorite part of my room. I feel like if your bed is not put together, it could really make or break your entire room because it's like the focal point. You know what I mean? Everybody's looking to see what the bed looks like. Well, I am when I watch these videos. This is a full-size bed, if anybody was wondering, in this space. I'm going to try to see if I could figure out the square footage of this room so you can get an idea of how large it is. Or small, however you want to look at it. Most of my bedding comes from Macy's. So these Euro shams are from Macy's. The pillows in the back are from Macy's. These two throw pillows are from At Home, the black one and this gray one. And then the lumbar pillow is also from Macy's. And the white sheets and pillowcases, I normally get them from like Home Goods or Marshalls, and I buy a lot of white sheets, y'all. I'm very big on changing out my sheets once a week, and then I change my pillowcases even more frequently than that. So I just buy, anytime I see white sheets on sale, I just buy them so that I could change them out as much as possible to keep it clean and crisp. This comforter is also from Macy's. I love it. It's a beautiful black velvet texture. It also comes with a pillow set as well. I just don't have that on my bedding right now. And this throw, which is also a favorite of mine, this throw is from Our House. It's a nice wolf fur, and then it has like fleece lining. It's so warm, so comfortable. I love the little pom-poms. I think it adds such a beautiful, like, it's just a little oomph, you know what I mean? Just a nice little extra piece of detail to it. I definitely think this throw makes the bed. Without this throw, the bed would be cute, but it wouldn't be the same. Look at the pom-poms. It just freaking makes the bed. So here's my little candle tray. This candle tray also was very intentional. Like I said, every piece in my room, I was very mindful of what I was buying, why I was buying it, what it meant to me. I know that's extra, but I'm telling y'all, when you wake up to a bedroom that inspires you, that gives you good vibes, that you feel is speaking to you, when you are being petty one day and you get in an argument with family, friend, a boo, and you look at this, you look at this piece of artwork from Miloff, and you're just like, okay, I can't be petty, you know? It does something different to your spirit and to your state of mind. So this candle set is no different from that. This is my lip balm from the brand Hen, and I shared this with you guys in my What's in My Bag video. I showed you the lotion that I got from her. This is her lip balm. It's also a clean product, which I love. And then my hand lotion is from Byredo in Rose. These candles are probably my favorite in this little set. These candles, this one and this one, is from a brand called Melted Element. And what I love about this brand is they make their candles based off of certain countries, certain places. The scent is supposed to remind you of that place or give you, you know, those vibes. So when I saw these two candles, I got so excited because one of my dream destinations, my dream vacation spot is Dubai, and then also the Maldives. And I was like, oh my god, they have both of my spots. And then back here, that's another candle from the set that I mentioned from IKEA. And then this, which I have lit right now, is my heart chakra candle. I got this from either Marshall's or Home Goods. And again, another thing that I had for last year and for this year is that I wanted to invite more trust, love, and compassion in my life. Literally, those were the words that I used. And I saw this candle and I was like, oh, I need her. And then this, my baby. Look how beautiful this jar is, y'all. Oh, she cute. She's so cute. I freaking love this jar. I am so happy that I actually really adore the scent of this candle. This candle is from a company called Voluspa. Voluspa. It is their Moso bamboo scent. And when I tell y'all, this smells like Christmas time. I know you can't smell it, but smell it. It smells like Christmas. And Christmas is one of my favorite. It is the only holiday that I recognize, okay? The last thing on this tray is my diffuser. This diffuser I purchased from Anthropologie. She's a little hurt because this was not originally this color. It was like a nice cream color, kind of like this. But the flower itself is the diffuser stick. So all the oils got into this and, you know, became discolored. But I kind of like it, you know. For some reason, it like adds to the whole little boutique, antique sort of vibe that I was going for. I purchased this tray off of West Elm. It's their cafe tray, the larger size. I don't know if this is still available, but again, it'll be linked below if it is. I love this tray so much. I'll use this tray even to eat on. Like, I'll set my candles aside, and if I want to have have, you know, a nice little breakfast in bed or something fancy, I'll lay out the food on this tray. It's such a gorgeous tray. And of course it's mirrored. I'm a huge fan of mirrored trays. I think that's it for the whole room. I think we're done. That was so simple. That's my bedroom, y'all.
All right, Bells, that's it for my room tour. I hope you enjoyed the tour. Hopefully it inspired you to do something a little extra with your own bedroom. Everything that I showed, if I could find it, I'll link it below in the description if you're interested in purchasing it for yourself. And of course, if you feel like you are part of this tribe, make sure you subscribe and I will catch you. I'll catch you in the next video. Bye. You feel like you part of this tribe, make sure you subscribe.